Tragic news last night with Joe Frazier, the former heavyweight champ of the world in the sport of boxing. We bring in longtime boxing writer Robert Exel, the editor-in-chief of Boxing.com, to talk about it. Robert, how are you?
I'm good. How are you, Rick?
Doing good. Joe Frazier passing away at the age of 67. Unfortunately, from liver cancer, he lost his battle last night. Can you talk a little bit about covering Joe Frazier? Because you were around when he fought, and I'm sure it was a special time for boxing when he was around.
Well, it really was. It was really the golden age of heavyweights. There were so many contenders, all of whom would probably be heavyweight champion today were it not for the extreme size of the Klitschkos. But Frazier was terrific. He was a fighting machine. I mean, if ever a man was born to fight, it was Joe Frazier. He came up real hard scrabble beginnings, born in Beaufort, South Carolina, the youngest of 13 children. His father was a sharecropper with one arm. Frazier, that was his environment. The land wasn't good. They grew cotton. They grew watermelon, but that was about it. He watched boxing on TV. His father got a black and white TV, and he saw Sugar Ray Robinson fight. He saw Willie Pep. He saw Rocky Graziano. He saw Marciano. He saw some of the all-time greats. And his uncle said, quite casually, someday that boy's going to be another Joe Louis. And Frazier took those words to heart. He got an old burlap bag, filled it with leaves and rags and corn cobs, and started training as a child. And he took to it. Moved to Philadelphia, worked in a slaughterhouse, became an amateur fighter, tore through the amateur ranks, won a gold medal in the 1964 Tokyo Olympics as a late replacement for Buster Mathis, who was injured, and turned pro the next year. And again, he was a force of nature, and one of the best left hooks in the business, an absolutely thrilling performer, always forward moving, never say die, quit was not in his vocabulary. And he tore through the ranks. And within 5 years, he had won the title from Jimmy Ellis and was heavyweight champion.
A lot of people know about Muhammad Ali and they know about George Foreman, but what did Joe Frazier mean to the sport of boxing?
Well, Frazier was really a class act. Ali, of course, was totally in sync with the zeitgeist, the spirit of the times. Ali was Ali. There's only one Muhammad Ali. Frazier, in his way, was sort of old school and sort of old fashioned. And whereas Ali was wearing a black suit and a white shirt and a black bow tie, sort of being in sync with the black Muslims, all of which is a very radical time, Frazier was wearing a pimp hat and wearing furs. And he was very sort of old fashioned, kind of retrograde, you know, sort of 50s in a way. But a really decent character. I mean, a really real gentleman and a simple man. I mean, not a complicated person like Ali, but a simple man. And that simplicity, in its way, translated into the ring as well. He was not a fancy Dan. He wasn't quick on his feet, but he was forward moving. He came to fight. And he would hit whatever was in front of him, he would hit, whether it was elbows, whether it was arms, whether it was face, whether it was chest, stomach. I mean, he was a fighting machine, and an impeccable fighting machine at that.
You said that he was a simple man. What kind of person was he away from the ring?
Kind, generous, considerate, polite, All of those qualities were part of why he had so much trouble with Ali, who made such a jest at Frazier's expense, calling him names, calling him Uncle Tom, calling him a gorilla. I mean, this was Ali elevating trash talk to the art of, I'm not sure what exactly the word is, but it was Ali's trash talk. And Frazier was not given to trash talk. He was a decent character. He was from the South. Ali was from the South, too. But Ali was from a middle-class background. Frazier was not. You know, dirt poor, Beaufort, South Carolina. And he didn't like it. And there was no reason for him to like it. Ali was a master at building up the gate and a master of building up a gate at his opponent's expense. And Frazier was the person who suffered as a result.
Joe Frazier fought Muhammad Ali three times. He fought George Foreman. He had some tough fights. Could you name one of his best fights of all time?
Well, there are a few that are really excellent. His fight, first fight with Jerry Quarry, was just exceptional. Quarry was an amazing fighter himself. That was a terrific fight. And, of course, his first fight with Ali, which is called The Fight, which is was at Madison Square Garden, and it was Ali's first fight back after his three-and-a-half-year hiatus. And Frazier beat Ali. Ali was the deposed champion, but he had never lost. Ali came back, decided he wanted to get his title back, which Frazier had won from Ellis, and he lost. It was a terrific performance. Frazier not only won the, not only beat Ali, but he also knocked Ali down, which was really something.
And that's only happened to Muhammad Ali three times in his career. Is there ever, has there ever been a better nickname than Smoking Joe Frazier?
It was certainly appropriate. I mean, boxing is filled with great nicknames, but that one was certainly appropriate. He was smoking. I mean, there's no question about it. Again, like a steam engine, or like a bull going after a matador. He was definitely Smoking Joe Frazier.
Again, Joe Frazier dead at the age of 67. Last question for you, Robert. Do you think that he is more than deserving of a statue in Philadelphia?
I certainly think so. I'm not a great lover of statues, but if anybody is deserving of a statue in Philadelphia, he certainly is. If Sylvester Stallone, a.k.a. Rocky, has a statue, and he's a fictional character, certainly a factual character like Joe Frazier deserves at least as much.
You would absolutely think so. Again, Joe Frazier dead at the age of 67, losing his fight to liver cancer. Robert Exel, thank you very much for coming on and talking about it. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Rick.